Hey, good afternoon, folks. It's Chris Lita with the Fisherman Magazine. We're in early spring, and while the masses are out trout fishing, we're going to do a little plan B today. We're going to go target some deep water bluegills, and we're going to do it with some jigs, and it's a pleasant alternative to the spring trout madness that's going on the streams right now. I drove by the river, and it was wall to wall, so we're going to get into the early spring bluegill pattern and see if we can get some big palm-sized gills. Stay tuned as you come along with us here at the Fisherman Magazine and thefisherman.com.
Now we're hooked up. Keith's got one on. Let's see what we got here. Oh, another nice deep water bluegill. It's a nice slabber. And that'll do the job. Nice fish. On a spring day out deep water. We're out over about 6 to 8 feet right now and just bouncing those jigs right along the bottom. There we go. There's a little, in addition to bluegills, I'm getting a couple of these beautiful pumpkin seeds. Look at that jig right there in the mouth. But nice colors on that fish. Yeah, took the jig. We're not alone out here, as you can see. There's a big turtle just taking off right there. There he comes. He's coming right under the boat. He just went down. Oh, I'm getting a little bite over here. The jig bouncing there and the fish are just hitting it right under the kayak. Once you find them, it's pretty fast action. Keith's casting in. It's pretty steep drop off here. Oh, there's another hit.
Jig's all messed up.
Yeah. Oh, got one following it now. Now let's get this guy unhooked. Well, we're into him pretty good here. They're starting to move a little bit more shallow than we've been catching them. Even the resident bass are coming out to play. Keith's got a little bass, so we always catch a lot of little small bass in on the jigs, too. Now it looks 10 pounds. Well, we're headed in after a little bit of deep water bluegill action. Had some bluegills, we had some crappies. We had a good little bite going, so time to head in and put the kayak up on the truck and head for home.
Hey folks, I just want to take a quick moment here to show you what's been working today. We're using super ultralight jigs. This happens to be a 1/16th ounce with a chartreuse twister, if you can get a close look at that. And then also, it's just a little box with everything I need. Sometimes a float was working today. We used a float with a jig below it and a couple of different varieties. This happens to be the one that was really working. That's a 1/32nd ounce jig head. It's about as light as you can get without it being called a fly. So just real quick, the tactic that we employed today was a very slow retrieve with that jig just floating over the bottom. So I'm gonna throw it out, I'm gonna let it sink, but I'm not gonna let it hit the bottom. I'm just gonna work it almost like a swim bait off the bottom. Slow drags and pauses, and those bluegills were hitting it when that jig was kind of falling down. There'd be a little tick in the line, or when you'd reel back up, you'd feel that resistance and know that you had a fish on. So real quick, I'll do it one more time, and the fish were very active coming out of the deep water. So I throw out, I let it sink a little bit, and then I start that slow drag and twitch with the rod held high, watching the line where it enters the water for a strike. For those of you who want to give something different a try and are maybe tired of fighting the crowds on trout streams, give bluegills a try. They'll be in the deep water this early season, moving shallow as we look forward to a great summer here at The Fisherman. Chris Lito, New Jersey editor of The Fisherman Magazine, reporting.